know why coffee dissolves so slowly in cold water, but dissolves so quickly in hot water? Or why milk goes off so quickly on a sunny day if it's not put in the fridge? Well, it's all to do with the rate of reaction. Understanding how fast a chemical change takes place and the factors that affect it helps chemists explain things and plan how to carry out reactions quickly but safely in industry. For a reaction to occur, there must be a successful collision between two or more particles. The particles need enough kinetic energy and to collide the right way around. As the number of successful collisions per unit time increases, so does the rate of reaction. Factors that affect the rate of reaction include temperature, surface area, concentration, pressure, and catalysts. In this experiment, we'll investigate how concentration affects the rate of reaction. To do this, I'm going to react sodium thiosulfate with hydrochloric acid to produce sodium chloride, water, sulfur dioxide gas, and sulfur. The sulfur produced in this reaction forms a yellow-white precipitate, which makes the liquid cloudy. We can time how long it takes to reach a certain level of cloudiness by timing how long it takes not to be able to see a black cross through it. You can find the full methodology, safety information, and activities in the supporting resources. Before we start, put your safety glasses on and make sure you're in a well-ventilated room. We're going to make 5 different concentrations of sodium thiosulfate solution by diluting with distilled water. Let's start with our first concentration, A. Using a measuring cylinder, measure 10 centimeters cubed of sodium thiosulfate solution. And then pour it into the conical flask. Next, measure 40 centimeters cubed of distilled water and add it to the conical flask. Now, I'm placing the conical flask on top of the black cross. Now, using a clean measuring cylinder, measure 10 centimeters cubed of hydrochloric acid. To make sure it's a fair test, we need to control other variables. So I'm making sure the volume and concentration of the hydrochloric acid is the same each time, and the temperature too. I'm going to add the acid to the conical flask and start the stop clock. I'm then going to give the reactants a swirl. Time how long it takes until you can no longer see the cross. Look at it from the same distance, at least 20 centimeters above each time, and take care not to breathe in any of the toxic sulfur dioxide fumes. Limit the amount of sulfur dioxide gas released into the classroom by placing a watch glass on top of the conical flask. When you can't see the cross, I can't see it now, stop the clock and write down the time. The time is 3 minutes and 44 seconds, which is the same as 224 seconds. Make sure you pour the reaction mixture into the stop bath and rinse the conical flask immediately with distilled water to avoid sulfur sticking to the flask. It can be hard to know exactly when the reaction's over and when to stop the clock. We therefore do 3 repeats and record the results each time. We are now going to change the concentration of sodium thiosulfate solution using different volumes of sodium thiosulfate and water to see how concentration affects rate. For concentrations B, C, and D, measure out the volumes of sodium thiosulfate in the results table and add water to make the total volume of sodium thiosulfate and water 50 centimeters cubed each time. Repeat the rest of the steps you did for A, record the times in the results table, and do 3 repeats. For concentration E, use 50 centimeters cubed of sodium thiosulfate solution and no water. Then pour it in and place the flask on the black cross. Then measure and add 10 centimeters cubed of hydrochloric acid into this measuring cylinder. Just like before, pour the hydrochloric acid in the conical flask and press start on the stopwatch. Then make sure to give your conical flask a quick swirl. Stop the clock when you can no longer see the cross. It's 29 seconds. Repeat twice more. Here are all the times in seconds. Now, I've carried out 3 repeats of 5 different sodium thiosulfate concentrations. We need to calculate the concentrations and the average times. To work out the concentrations of A to E, we need to know what we started with. The sodium thiosulfate stock bottle says 40 grams per decimeter cubed. As I added no water to E, we know that the concentration of sodium thiosulfate in E was 40 grams per decimeter cubed. To work out the other concentrations, we need to apply our math skills. For experiment A, there was 10 centimeters cubed sodium thiosulfate in a total volume of 50 centimeters cubed. 10 divided by 50 equals 0.2. We then multiply 0.2 by the concentration of the stock bottle, which was 40 grams per decimeter cubed, to get 8 grams per decimeter cubed as our concentration for A. You can work out the concentration of sodium thiosulfate in B, C, and D in the same way. To calculate the mean average time for each concentration, add up the times and then divide by the total number of times. However, if you have any anomalies, which are results that don't follow the trend, do not include them when working out the average. You can then draw a graph to see how the concentration of sodium thiosulfate affects the rate of reaction. As you increase the concentration of sodium thiosulfate, the time it takes for you not to be able to see the black cross decreases. Find more activities, including drawing graphs, in the supporting resources on the RSC educational website. This reaction is exothermic, so it may affect the temperature and accuracy of your results. To better control the temperature and improve accuracy, we could do the experiment in a water bath. Keep the temperature constant and below 50 degrees Celsius to limit the toxic sulfur dioxide gas released. You can also use a light sensor to monitor the sulfur production to improve accuracy. Using a light sensor avoids peering down the flask and reduces the risk of breathing in sulfur dioxide gas. The light sensor can give an exact time when you reach a particular light intensity value and is more consistent than human observation. Place a light sensor under the flask and see how long it takes for the reading to reach the chosen light intensity value. Find more rates of reaction experiments and further details in the supporting resources on the RSC Education website. Thank you for watching and have fun with your experiments.